facial artery. So let's start with the facial artery from below. We can see this is the facial artery that I have lifted up here. The facial artery is the third branch of the external carotid, which we have not dissected out yet. As the facial artery ascends up, it goes under the ramus of the mandible, where my finger has gone in. And then it curves around and it hooks under the lower border of the body of the mandible. And then it climbs up. And here it does a number of things. It forms a very deep groove on the posterior aspect of the submandibular gland when it is located in the submandibular triangle. And we can see the submandibular gland here, and we can see the facial artery is coming a curve here. And you can see it is closely related to the submandibular triangle and the submandibular gland. As it climbs up here, at the place where it crosses the body, the lower margin of the body of the mandible, it is just in front of the masseter muscle, and this is the masseter muscle. So this is the place where we can feel the pulsation of the facial artery in a normal person, where my finger is located and where my instrument is located. Thereafter, the facial artery climbs up obliquely on the side of the face. It is located medial to the facial vein. If you notice, the facial artery is highly tortuous, and we can see the tortuosity right from its origin all the way up. The reason for its tortuosity is because it is located within the facial muscles, and facial muscles are constantly in motion. And therefore, to compensate for the motion, this artery is tortuous. Now let's take a look at the branches going from below up. We can see, apart from the branches it gives to the submandibular gland, we can see a branch going to the chin, under the surface of the chin. This is the submental artery. The next branch that we can see here is going to the lower lip, and we can see that branch here. This is the inferior labial artery. Then the main facial artery, it goes under the muscles. And we can see it is going under this muscle, and it is coming up here again. As it climbs up, it gives another branch to the upper lip, and that is known as the superior labial artery. This superior labial artery also gives another branch called the septal branch. And this septal branch of the superior labial artery participates in a plexus on the anterior part of the septum, which is known as the Kiesselbach plexus, and which is the site which is responsible for epistaxis. The facial artery then continues up on the side of the face, lateral to the nose, medial to the facial vein, and here in the region of the nose, we cannot see because it is very small, it gives a branch to the nose, and that is known as the lateral nasal artery. And then as it further climbs up, once it crosses the lower margin of the orbit, then it becomes known as the angular artery. And here it finishes by giving superior and inferior palpebral branches. So this is the full course of the facial artery. Apart from the branches to the face, it also gives some other branches which are not in the face. One, it is the ascending palatine artery, which supplies the soft palate and the pharynx. And this ascending palatine artery, as it's climbing up, it climbs deep inside, it gives a branch to the tonsil, that is the tonsillar branch. Apart from that, the facial artery itself also gives a tonsillar artery. This tonsillar artery and the tonsillar branch is also one of the sites which is responsible for hemorrhage after tonsillectomy. That's all for now about the facial artery. Thank you very much for watching. Dr. Sanjoy Sanyal signing out. Anderson is the camera person. If you have any questions or comments, please put them in the comment section below. Have a nice day.